It's the final chapter of the season then here at the spectacular Yas Marina Circuit. It's a race where the pole sitter failed to finish in three of the first four events. A front row start here is by no means a guarantee of victory, so we go into battle once more as we get underway at the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. The Yas Marina Circuit, just over 3.4 miles long with 21 corners and two very long back straights. There are two DRS zones going into the heavy braking zones of both Turn 8 and Turn 11 and offer plenty of potential for overtaking. The circuit comes with its fair share of tricky corners as well, in particular 15, 16 and 17, which will certainly test a driver's braking management. Anthony Davidson is with me one last time this year as we bid a fond farewell to another great season of Formula One.
It's been another great year of racing, but let's not look back just yet. We've still got one more Grand Prix ahead of us. Some of these drivers don't know if they'll be in the sport next year or how competitive their car might be even if they are. So this is a race where every driver should be striving to make the most of it.
With the race minutes away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Charles Leclerc lines up on pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Bottas, Ocon, Daniel Ricciardo, and Vettel, Verstappen, Sainz, Norris, and Pierre Gasly, Perez, Kvyat, the rookie, and De Vries, Stroll, Giovinazzi, George Russell, and Roman Grosjean, Latifi, Correa, Albon, and Kevin Magnussen fills the last spot on the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
Okay, let's finish the season with a strong effort. System checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of the lap. No rain expected for the time being. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid has formed. Be ready with the clutch. Let's focus now for the rest of the race. Will be enabled this lap. You can use it when within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. The car behind is dropping back by about 3/10 a lap. Reaching a danger point with the wear on the MGUH. Overheating the engine will exacerbate the issue, so keep the temps under control. We're seeing a loss of power from the turbocharger now. Loss of power on the turbo. behind is dropping back by about 0.3 a lap. P13. fuel target is +1. Faster engine modes are available. Is coming in for his stop. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the softs. Into P2, that's P2 now. Box, we're coming in this lap. DRS is offline. The rear wing is down, so you can stay out while we work on a fix. Using a small amount of time to the car behind, keep pushing. Go now. Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track. top 10 now. Keep it up. Is in the pits. Is looking really good. You're managing it well. The car in front is 3.7 seconds. Is in the pits. Nick in the pits. safety gap to the car ahead is 3.2 seconds. The teammate behind is 20.6 seconds. What happened? Let me know you're okay. To the car in front is 8.7 seconds. The car behind us is lapping faster than us by around 1 second per lap. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. To stay with him, he might make a mistake. He could still regain the position. There's 4 laps of fuel remaining. We're leading our teammate by 10.9 seconds. current gap ahead is 1.7 seconds. P7 now. P7. Signs ahead. Gap to car in front is 1.7 seconds. They're on old mediums. Norris is behind you. The gap behind us is 2.5 seconds. They're on old mediums. The distance to the leader is 24.3 seconds. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Two laps left. Next time by will be your final lap. This is your final lap. Final lap of the race. Dropping a second a lap to the car behind, 1 second. That's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
And so the celebrations begin, and well-earned they are indeed. It may have looked simple at times, but as any racing driver can tell you, competing at this level, at the very top, is anything but simple. There's no counting them now then. We have a new World Drivers' Champion. Victory today then, but bittersweet emotions, I'm sure, as the championship slips through their fingers. Even so, what a fantastic final race of the season this was. What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
I feel like consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalize on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
I have to give it to the rookie. They fought so hard and had incredible pace at times, so I don't think anyone else did a better job today.
It's another clear win for Mercedes as they managed to secure the constructors' title. An incredible performance for the whole team. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.